You might know that Mexico has a rich food culture, starting from tasty tacos on the streets, delicious tamales, moles, enchiladas, and tons of salsas. And you can find this incredible food for very reasonable prices. It's very well known that a lot of people from other parts of the world travel to Mexico just because of the food. And who's going to deny those tasty tacos al pastor, barbacoa, carnitas, enchiladas, chilaquiles with a little bit of meat? All these tasty food has something in common. Almost all of them have meat. We Mexicans really like meat. If you're a vegetarian or vegan, you may have a difficult time trying to find food with no meat. In Mexico, 19% of the population with internet access don't eat meat. I've probably started to see this tendency about 6 years ago, 8 years ago with people I know or in Instagram. Instagram is one of the main sources where you can find very tasty vegan food as well. We have a lot of fruits and vegetables, and we can buy them for very reasonable prices. We also have a ton of markets, big, enormous markets where we can buy seeds, we can buy our rice for very few pesos. And I've seen that there are more and more vegetarian and vegan restaurants. And don't worry, I don't want to persuade you to become vegan, because I am not vegan. So I grew up thinking that veganism was boring, or that I couldn't enjoy all the food and the things that I really enjoy eating. There were very huge misconceptions that I had. So I kept eating those tasty tacos and enchiladas, and I saw the consequences. At some point, I had a big belly and my cheeks were bigger. So I stopped eating this tasty food every day, and I discovered a healthy way of eating. Actually, I can tell you my story about how I escaped my bad diet here in Mexico when I was younger. I remember I was 20 years old, 22 more or less. So it was the first time that I was earning my salary, so I would eat out on the streets, and you know. If you want me to tell you that story, let me know in the comments. So as I said, when I was younger, I remember that I would eat tacos on the street stalls because they were cheaper and very, very tasty. They would fill me up for probably the rest of the day. But when I was a child, I would live with my grandma, and I remember that my grandma would cook every day at home because it was cheaper. She would always cook a lot of vegetables, rice, soup, sometimes chicken soup. So meat was something very, very special for us. And once in a while, we would buy with my mom and my family those tasty tacos. Now as an adult, I try to eat healthier, and I try to include more vegetables in our diet. So I went out to show you some places that I like to eat. I hope you enjoy these places. And at the same time, if you are interested in coming to Querétaro, I think, and if you are vegetarian or vegan, this might be useful for you. I'm going to have my breakfast here. Let's go. ¿Y qué otra cosa no tiene absolutamente nada de carne aquí?
Los tamalitos.
Los tamales.
Están hechos con un poco de aceite y llevan queso en vez de carne.
Gracias. Atole champurrado. And you?
This one is yogurt with walnut, so it's not completely vegan, but vegetarian.
The lady said that they do it here, so natural yogurt. If you didn't know what champurrado is, it's based on corn, chocolate, water, and cinnamon.
Never seen the drink like this before.
Do you want to try it?
Try
it.
Wow.
It's good?
It's so good.
So I'm having having a mushroom burger. And Kat, what are you having?
I have soy.
Soy
burger. Cheers. I love the bun.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
It's good. Very soft.
It's like, what, 35 or so? That's really cheap. You know, when it comes to the niche of vegetarian food, vegan food, it tends to be expensive. Like, when, for example, when I was in New York City, if you go to the restaurant that cater to vegetarian food, vegan food, it's drastically expensive.
Yeah. So the next place that I want to show you, I really like it very much because they have a good flavor on every food. They follow the rule of menú del día, which is, you know, they have a soup, a main dish, a dessert, agua del día, which is water of the day, like agua de Jamaica, agua de horchata. If not, they can prepare tasty burgers, but I already have a burger in the morning. I know that's weird, but let's see what else do they have to offer. Okay, guys, we're finally here. Let's go. Me dijo André que se habían cambiado. Let's go, guys. Let's see what they're cooking. Beto is going to prepare some tasty tacos. There's a lot of pressure because he is his first time on the camera. So let's see how it goes. Okay, tacos, ¿de qué van a hacer, Beto? Okay.
Es como muy parecido al bistec de los tacos que encuentras en la esquina. Los cocinamos como muy estilo uruguayo porque llevan un chimichurri uruguayo. Que le dan un toque especial al taco, ¿no?
¿Hicieron
el chimichurri?
Sí, aquí hacemos todo.
¿Cómo,
de
dónde sacaron la receta?
Bueno, a mí me gusta mucho porque, bueno, sí la hacen muy sabrosa, tiene muy buen sazón. Pero independientemente de eso, se me hace una alternativa, una comida muy sana.
¿Entonces usted ya no come carne o está dejando?
Estoy dejando. Como muy poquita, casi no, pero precisamente porque no encontraba otras opciones, pero encontrando la opción, sí, y también el costo es muy accesible.
Sí.
Aquí, ¿verdad?
Que es una sal ya preparada con paprika, sal de ajo en polvo, cebolla en polvo.
Para que agarre el saborcito, ¿no? Mejor.
Sí.
¿Qué tan seguro te sientes de tus tacos?
Muy seguro.
This is so good, but Dave, my husband, hasn't eaten, so I'm going to bring a burger for my husband. ¿De qué hamburguesas tienes, Beto?
Tenemos hamburguesas de portobello, lenteja, quinoa, también ha pegado muy bien, son muy ricas.
Sí, ok, entonces una hamburguesa de la más parecida a la carne.
¿La casi casi?
La casi casi. Okay.
Pues buscábamos alternativas para comer, porque Andrei, Aline y otros dos hijos que tengo son veganos. Y yo estaba en la nueva cultura del cuidado de la alimentación. Pues buscábamos alternativas para la cena, por ejemplo, y no encontrábamos puros tacos de carnita, etcétera, ¿no? Entonces, pues son ricos, pero ya no son tan saludables. Y aparte los muchachos, pues,
no comían.
En el veganismo, pues siempre estaban buscando qué.
No se encuentra tan fácil.
No.
Queremos algo así rápido y puro taco. Ni verdurita le ponen, ni nada.
Lo más que le ponen es el cilantro y la cebolla,
¿sí?
¿No? Entonces, pues yo les decía, pues si no encuentran, pues abran un lugar, ¿no? Pues en lo que te lo estoy contando, dije, pues yo lo abro si ustedes no quieren. Así surgió el proyecto.
From my understanding, veganism isn't a diet. It's a set of ethical principles to abide by. I think food is a very affordable comfort, and the amount of comfort people have on their lives usually depends on their financial status. I think the less comfortable we are, the less we are to give up.
Yo soy de la Ciudad de México, entonces, por ejemplo, ahí no me cuesta tanto trabajo porque hay cientos de establecimientos veganos, pero, por ejemplo, cuando salgo ya sea Querétaro o a los alrededores de la Ciudad de México, que no todo está, que todo está tan centralizado allá, me cuesta un poco más porque las opciones todavía son muy pocas, aunque ya se está viendo que hay cada vez más y más gente interesada en el tema.
Sí.
Realmente las opciones son muy pocas, ¿no? Y los horarios pues todavía los son más reducidos.
Sí.
Justo, ¿no? Sí. Cuando nosotros empezamos el proyecto nos dimos cuenta que hay muchos vegetarianos y veganos aquí en Querétaro. Mm. No es que no haya vegetarianos ni haya veganos, más bien no hay opciones, ¿no? Mm. Entonces, por eso también quisimos ser una opción más. Sí. Y hemos estado ahí haciendo experimentos donde pues realmente empezamos a consumir platillos que ya ni siquiera nos dan ganas de extrañar lo que antes comíamos. Por ejemplo, el mole de olla de mi abuela me encantaba, pero es con carne. Ajá. Nunca más volví a comer un mole de olla, ¿no? Hasta que lo hizo Beto y dije, ay, se parece al de mi abuela.
Oh, qué rico.
Y no más extrañarlo, ¿no?
Sí. Oh, my God, guys, that food was awesome. I really like this place. I can tell the flavor is very similar to the Mexican flavor, even though they have different combinations. Come to this place, it's called La Semilla Verde. Thanks to all my patrons who are supporting this channel, guys. This is allowing me to visit more places, to make videos about these places. Thank you very much. And if you are a patron, you just give me a like and subscribe to this channel if you like this channel. See you in the next video. Adios.